Let's get started with osmolarity. In this lecture, we're going to learn physiology, man, your body fluid component, and osmolarity. And also, you need to know the difference between osmolarity and tonicity. And the last one is we're going to look at the real cell, the red blood cell, how they behave in different tonic solutions. Physiology man, so it's about 154 pounds. In the mid-20th century, the American Physiology Society decided to use a standardized people because different body weight person can have different amount of water. So they decided to use the average. And in the mid-20th century, they used the old Caucasian male average. And apparently in the 20th century, people are skinnier. So the average is about 154 pounds. And during the test or in the textbook, if they say they did not mention this person's body weight, we used the standardized person. I call it the physiology man, so it's about 154 pounds. And let's look at the standardized person, the physiology man, what's his total body water, what's his plasma osmolarity, and what's his blood volume and body water distribution. Physiology man is about 154 pounds, so let's transfer it to kilogram because we use the metric system in science. We use the kilogram, not pounds. So you transfer the pound into kilogram, you take this number, multiply 0.454, you get 70 kilograms. So if your body weight is 70 kilograms, you are the physiology man. And in your body, about 60% is water. If you are a baby, you have more. So baby have about 70% water. So that's why they are chubby. Old person, they have a little bit less. So they have about 50%. And young adult, most of us, we have about 60% water. So if you really want to lose weight, don't do that. You're going to get hurt. And you can stop drinking water. Because every day you lose about 2 liters of water. And you lose 2 kilograms, and it's gonna hurt you because your body's body water need to be maintained. So the total body water, you take 70 multiply about 60%, that's 42 kilograms. So your body have a lot of water, 42 liters, because 1 liter of water is 1 kilogram. So turn out this 42 liters of water. And your plasma osmolarity, in physiology we use the unit OSM or milli-OSM, you're going to learn how to calculate this. And in those 42 liters of water, about 2/3 of them stay in your cell. So in your body, you have trillion of cells. And inside the cells, we call the ICF, intracellular fluid, about 2/3 of them, the water stay inside. And 1/3 of them stay in the outside, we call the ECF, extracellular fluid. And in those ECF, you have about 1/4 of them that's in your blood and in the plasma part. And the other 75% that between cells, we call the interstitial fluid. And this is your body fluid component. Last time, we spent a lot of time talking about the cell membrane. And this is a cell membrane. So this inside the cell, this outside the cell. So the environment inside the cell is called intracellular fluid. And you also learned the intracellular fluid environment and extracellular fluid environment are different. In intracellular fluid, they have a lot of potassium. And because of the sodium-potassium pump, last time I told you this, the AC working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, it will keep pumping potassium in. So inside is a lot of potassium. And 1/3 of them stay outside. That's the ECF, extracellular fluid. And the sodium-potassium pump pumps sodium out. So the extracellular fluid has high sodium. Intracellular fluid has high potassium. And we spent a lot of time talking about the membrane proteins last time. So now today, let's focus on the fluid part. So in the ECF, you have about 1/4 of them stay in your blood. That's a plasma. So when we do the calculation, we found, about 8% of them stay in the plasma. And the other is called the interstitial fluid. That's the body fluid stay between the cells. So that shows you your your body, that's your cells. And inside, we call an ICF, intracellular fluid. And this part, plasma, that has water. And then this is the water between the cell. This is called the interstitial fluid. This fluid, some patient, they lie in bed for too long. And it turned out their circulation is not optimized. They can have edema. Edema is you have a lot of liquid. Because the heart, we're going to talk about the heart, going to push the blood out. And the capillary is a very leaky area. And the water can be pushed out. So the plasma constantly being pushed out. When they've been pushed out, we call the interstitial fluid, they will stay here. But most of them will go back. In the end part of the capillary, when they are close to the venule, the small vein area, the liquid will be pushed back because of the pressure. They will be pushed back because of the osmotic pressure. And also, some of the interstitial fluid will be pushed to the lymphatic system. So you will have the lymphatic vessel, and their job is to accumulate those interstitial fluid and also absorb lipid. So in your digestive system, when you eat your carbohydrate, your protein, they are absorbed through the blood vessel capillary, but the lipid is mainly absorbed through the lymphatic vessel. So those fluid will also go to the lymphatic vessel. So for the healthy person, you don't have edema. So this amount in the interstitial fluid is constant. But for patients that lie in bed for too long, and they turn out their circulation being blocked, and that's because the liquid stay in the interstitial fluid, and that's edema. So that's the body water distribution. And you're gonna learn the unit we use in physiology. So in chemistry, you learn molarity. That's the percentage weight. That's the pretty normal unit you use in calculate concentration. But in physiology, we use osmolarity. Osmolarity is very similar to molarity. So if you look at the molarity, molarity is how many more this particles are dissolved in volume. That's a liter. And we use osmolarity in physiology. Osmolarity is the molarity multiplied dissociation factor. Dissociation factor is how many particles you really have in water, because in your body is mainly water. So when you put sodium chloride into water, it's not one particle, it's actually two, because it dissolved into the sodium ion and potassium ion. Chloride ion. So it becomes two particles. So the osmolarity for sodium chloride is 2. And when we calculate osmolarity, we just take the molarity. So if you have 1 m of sodium chloride in water, you multiply 2. Dissociation factor is 2. It becomes 2 osmol. So in physiology, we use osmolarity because it considers the real situation happen in your body. And if it's calcium chloride, CaCO2, and the dissociation factor will be 3, because apparently you put 1 calcium chloride into water, you actually have 3 particles. And that's why in physiology we use osmolarity. And glucose, dissociation factor is 1, right? You put 1 glucose into water, it's still 1 glucose. So the molarity of glucose is the same as osmolarity. And you're going to learn tonicity as well. Tonicity is different. Tonicity is, we talk about the solution. And we care about cell. We don't care about the solution. We don't care about the cell in physiology. We care about how the cell behave in the solution. And this tonicity. So if the solution makes the cell behave very quick, very happily, and nothing change, we got isotonic solution. And you will also learn, okay, what's hypertonic, what's the hypotonic, how they make the cell behave. And that's the tonicity part. Okay, let's do some simple calculation. And how do you create a 0.9% saline? This solution is pretty commonly used in the clinical field. You use it to clean your contact lenses. You use it to dilute all the IV solution, and there's a reason for it, because this is isotonic solution. So first, let's do the calculation, how to calculate a 0.9% sodium chloride solution into osmolarity. So 0.9% percentage weight, so 0.9%, you can make it in your own kitchen. So it tells you, okay, 0.9% is 9 gram of this solute dissolved in 1,000 gram of the solution. This 0.9% means. So you can prepare 9 gram of sodium chloride, and you prepare 1,000 gram of water. You can use 0.9 gram sodium chloride, 100 gram of water. If that make you understand this unit better, you can use it. I like to use 1,000 gram because 1,000 gram equals to 1,000 ml equals to 1 liter. So I just multiply everything by 10. You take 9 gram of sodium chloride, and you take 1,000 gram of water, and you mix them together, and they dissolve very quickly, become the solution, and that's the 0.9% saline. So you can boil it, and you can use it to clean your contact lenses, so you actually don't have to buy it. And that's 0.9% saline. And let's change it to osmolarity. Let's see how to change it to osmolarity. So first, you need to transfer it to more. How many more? And then transfer more into OS more, right? Okay, so you have 9 grams of sodium chloride, and to calculate the molarity, you have to divide by the molecular weight. So molecular weight, sodium chloride in the test, I will give you. Sodium is 23, chloride is 35.4, so together 58.5. That's the molecular weight. And you can memorize it, because during the test, I usually ask you two molecules. First one is sodium chloride, 58.4 gram per mole. And the second one is glucose. Glucose is 180 gram per mole. So if you can memorize these two, you'll be much quicker. And you take this 9 gram divided by the molecular weight, and you get, okay, that's the mole. That's how many more of it. Then you take the mole divide by the volume. That's why I like to use 1 liter, because the denominator become 1. Right? So now you have the molarity, 0.154 more. And in physiology, we like OS more. And the difference between the more and OS more is dissociation factor. So you take this number, multiply dissociation factor, and I told you the sodium chloride dissociation factor is 2. They dissolve into two particles in water. So you multiply 2, become 0.308, always the m. And become milli, you multiply 1,000 times. So you take this number, multiply 1,000, is 308 milli always m. It's about 300 milli always m. So we call this isotonic solution. Quickly, you will learn, okay, tonicity. We call this isotonic solution because this is the concentration. This is the concentration your body cells have. So when you inject this solution into your body, and the cells won't complain, they're pretty happy because that's the concentration they like. And in the next few slides, we're gonna learn, okay, what if you inject the one too high, too low into the body? What gonna happen to the cell? They won't be happy. And clinically, they use 0.9% saline because this is isotonic solution, and that's your body concentration. So for tonicity, we only have 3. And we talk about 0.9% saline. We use it to make all the IV solution. We don't use distilled water to make the IV solution. We use normal saline. We call it normal saline. And the reason is it's isotonic solution. So when you inject the solution into the blood, and the cells won't swell, won't shrink, and that's isotonic. If you put the solution into the cell, and turn out the cell shrink, and we say this concentration is too high. So we call it hypertonic solution. And we put the cells into the solution and turn out the cell swell, and we say the concentration is too low. So that's the hypotonic solution. So we only have 3 tonicity: isotonic, hypertonic, or hypotonic. Okay, let's take a break.